Springfield. The challenger today, Jack Quinn of Fremont, New Hampshire. Hello again. Welcome back to Candlepin Bowling. I'm Don Gillis, and you all know by now that this program is on videotape, and we sometimes tape it several weeks before you actually see the telecast. There is a constant, however. It is done here at Sammy White's Brighton Bowl. It is always three strings of Candlepin Bowling, and it is total pinfall which determines our winner. That winner is rewarded with a handsome marble-based trophy from the Ace Trophy Company of Boston. The runner-up receives a smaller but otherwise identical version, indicating he participated in our program. And as far as the money is concerned, well, let's start with a high-low jackpot today. 1-7-10 at the end of the show, if it's knocked down with the one ball, will be worth $575. And if neither bowler hits that, we'll add $25 and keep doing that till somebody does hit it. And there'll be $50 doled out for the winner of each of the three strings. An extra $100 if a bowler rolls a 400 series. For three marks in a row, any combination of strikes or spares in the same string, $50 in bonus money. Each subsequent consecutive mark in that same string would be worth $50 apiece. For three strikes in a row, an additional bonus of $1,000. And each subsequent consecutive strike after those three would be worth $1,000 each. I guess that's about it. Why don't we get started right after this? Okay, leading off today's challenger, Jack Quinn, Fremont, New Hampshire. Jack currently has a league average of 120. High single 180, high three 440. Jack Quinn had a 669 in winning his roll-off. And as you can tell by his 180 high single, 440 triple, and 120 average, he is a pretty good bowler. He's the daytime manager of the Lafayette Lanes, obviously is representing Lafayette. There it is. Now, our defending champion, Jeff Atkins. He has won four in a row, going for number five. No! 129 average. A scintillating 205 high single, and an ominous, if you will, 514 high triple. Ominous to an opponent, awesome to contemplate. Jeff is married and father of two, and he is a letter carrier for the United States Postal Service. Two full on the head pin, winds up with a clipped wing spread eagle. Nice effort. Jeff is representing the Westfield Bowling Center. Challenger Jack Quinn, who has some vocal support, as you can tell behind me, about to roll a bonus ball on a spare in the second. Six, and a nice piece of wood in the back in front of the eight pin. Nine box. Jack is married father of one, but probably father of two on the day that this is aired, because as we are taping this, Mrs. Quinn is expecting. Mentioned the high-low jackpot is at $575. The home viewer jackpot has begun all over again at $50. Yes, we did have a winner last week. And to refresh your memory as to what we're talking about, the home viewer jackpot is the guess by each of you out there on a postcard as to what the total pinfall both bowlers combined would be on a particular day when your card might be chosen. One card per day, the entry, and as soon as we have a winner, we dump out the big drum, which you will note is a lot later this week than it was last week. If your card is chosen, you will be guaranteed at least a couple of prizes, and if you happen to guess the correct total, both bowlers combined, within 10, either way, below or above the number, then you'll receive whatever is in the jackpot. Just send your cards, not letters, along to Candlepin Bowling, Channel 5, WCVB-TV, Needham, Massachusetts. 02192. Now we're going to take a little break here at the end of four. So the score at the end of four is challenger Jack Quinn, 41, with a bonus ball to roll, and defending champion Jeff Atkins, 37. Jack Quinn on the line to roll fifth frame. Actually, he's rolling a bonus ball on a spare in the fourth. Big eight. Tough spare leave. Oh, got it. A little sidewall action helps. Pretty shot. Those two pins to pick up for $50 in bonus money. He has it. $50 in bonus money. Now Jeff Atkins, our defending champion. Half was to right. Jeff's struggling a bit today, which is not the way it's been for the last 4 weeks, as he beat Alan Jones with a 370, Joe Donovan with a 410, Jim Putney with a 373, and Mike Sachar with a 390. Looking for that first one. Nine. All right, Jack Quinn has three in a row. So he's still alive for bonus money. half was to right. Just missing that head pin. All right. He'll have to start again if he's to get any bonus money. Eight box. Missed the head pin again, just slightly. Either side of that would have been, and probably to the right side of it, might have been a bit better. Nine. Jack Quinn, as you've noted, does not waste any time. He gets up there and fires away. Jeff, a little more deliberate. And Jeff's still looking for his first mark. There it is. Strike in the seventh. Seven on the first ball, and a chance to convert a spare. Either side of it. Eight is the fill. That closes him to within 15. Still 15. Now Jack Quinn, today's challenger. Yes! Some of these people who have come here to root for Jack are going to be hoarse before the second string is over. Now gives him another $50 in bonus money, and he has won this string, barring an absolute sensational finish. Oh, look at that thin hit. Just two, and it looked as if it were going to be more. 128. That hurt. Definitely not your average string for Jeff Atkins. Even 100 right now. 101, and he's down by 27 pins. So $50 in bonus money for winning the string to Jack Quinn, and $50 for three marks in a row, and he leads at the end of one, 128 to 101. In the middle string, our defending champion leads it off. He's Jeff Atkins. What a way to bounce back from that other string. Now, the question is, will he be able to keep it up? That close to two in a row. Single. Yes. Jack Quinn. Had a fine opening string of 128 in the event that you've just joined us. That one got away. He came back, though, to get the 10. Before I forget it, I want to remind you that the runner-up in today's show, as always, will receive a certificate for a Fisher's Space Pin. Yes. Okay, Jeff Atkins now has two marks in a row. Eight, and a chance for another. Tricky piece of wood there that may present a problem. You see the front one? Could divert the ball away. Let's see if he can get it. Hell, all right, he had to drive that. But there was always the danger of hitting it too far on the right side, which would have put the wood into the gutter and the ball would have been diverted to the right of that 4-7. $50 in bonus money for Jeff Atkins. Too bad. It was a good effort. Ten. That's what he's looking at. Nope. Good 10. Our congratulations to Barbara Marlowe, Ladies Pro Bowler of the Year on the WCBC. Carol Downey, the runner-up. And Male Bowler of the Year, Scott Williams. John Williams is runner-up. Congratulations to them both. And to Michelle Henderson for winning the last stop on the tour, and Mark Gregory for the men. Yes. 10. All right, once again, we are going to pause, catch you up to date. It was a 27-pin lead, as you can see, at the end of one for Jack Quinn, but Jeff Atkins has picked up 20 pins here. Score here after four in the middle string, Atkins 66, Quinn 46. Jeff Atkins, our defending champion, rolling in the fifth frame of the middle string as we're coming to the halfway point. He has closed the gap from 27 to 7. Half Worcester, right side. Oh, that close to coming back. The number five, still there, the kingpin. 10 box. Jeff's first appearance on our show was back almost 10 years ago in 1974. In December, to be exact, he challenged and lost to Dick Ewell. Little overcorrection that time, and you got a half Worcester on the other side. Second time Jeff came on, he won, and what a score. Rolled a 445. Shot for the 10. Pretty shot. Jack Quinn leads the match by 7, opposite a pair of 10s. Good spare lead. Jack's first appearance on our show was in 1979. In June, he lost in his first appearance. He lost to Steve Popolo. Fair. So he can add now to his 7-pin lead. Seven drop, fair lead. Just missed. Jack's second appearance on our show was a winning one, a 372 to beat Bob Papp. And the next week, he beat Jeff Canada. The following week, defeated Steve Johnson and finally lost to Tom Osta. That was in 1980, almost 4 years ago. Now, Jeff Atkins. Strike. Two strikes in a row. Ralph Stewart calls time momentarily to get a loose pin. Jack Quinn. Nice try. Ten. Kingpin still there. The walls came tumbling down, but the king is still there. Yes, he has a spare. And now here comes Jeff Atkins, and he has two strikes in a row.
about that? And he's still alive. And he's still alive. Two full on the head pin. All right. Okay, he had three strikes in a row. He's got $1,000 extra in bonus money. And, of course, had he gotten four in a row, it would have been $2,000. Nice 10 for a 166, and congratulations. Jack Quinn. Puts him at 110, but he has two marks in a row and a chance for some more bonus money. One twenty-one. And Jeff Atkins wins the middle string and picks up $50 in bonus money. He had three marks in a row twice in that string, $50 each, plus an extra $1,000 for three strikes in a row. So a pretty profitable string. $1,150 in that one string for Jeff Atkins. And the score at the end of two is defending champion Jeff Atkins of Springfield, 267, and challenger Jack Quinn of Fremont, New Hampshire, 249. Okay, third string, and challenger Jack Quinn leads it off. And he chopped wood on the left. An eight. Now, Jeff Atkins comes back up again. One interesting note, when Jeff hit his three strikes in a row, Jeff Jr. had to go to the bathroom, and wife Lisa took him, and she did not see it. She's seeing it now on television for the first time. Two full on the head pin. Okay, I have to apologize. Lisa says she did see it, but she was in the back of the crowd. Thank you. She's ordinarily sitting down just to my right here in the front, and she and Jeff Jr. left, and then presumably when she heard the first roar, she probably came out, but she says she did see it. Pins right now. That's the difference. 19 pins. Jack Quinn comes through with a strike. Boy, we are seeing lots of smudges up on that board. Al Giglio keeping score on the big board today. Bruce Goldman keeping score beside me. And lots of marks all over the sheet. Yes! Okay, Jack Quinn making a run right now at Jeff Atkins. In case you just joined us, he won the first string 128 to 101. Then Jeff came back with a sizzling 166 middle string to a 121 for Jack Quinn. To take at that time an 18-pin lead, which he has stretched to 19, but he's opposite two marks. Wood rolling, not quite off. It's all right, now he wants to go for that two pin. And there's Ralph Stewart, our lob line judge and referee. He made the spare. Phil Rubin is our producer and director, as always. And as always, Joanne Panto, our statistician and secretary. Seven. What a shot! Take a look at that again. That was a tough spare, and he made it. Oh, baby. What a beauty. Wasn't that worth another look?
Come on, Ralph.
All right, Jack Quinn has two marks in a row. Actually, each bowler has. See whether we can get any bonus money. Any more bonus money, I should say. Yes, he has three marks in a row and another $50 in bonus money. Did hurt.
Well,
Jeff Atkins. Gets himself eight and a chance for another $50. That hurt. That hurts some more. Seven pins now. Boy, he needed a big one, and he got it. The lead was down to seven. Yes. Pretty, pretty shot. Oh, are you seeing some bowling today? 83. What? Candlepin bowling today. 7 he picked up. And it's kind of a tough one to make because he can split these two pins without getting the back one. That's tough. That was tough. Nine. Now Jeff Atkins comes up. His lead cut to 7 in completed frames. However, he's got a strike opposite a 10. This stretches it from 7, whatever he gets in. Give him 6 more. He's up 13 is his lead right now. Wait a minute. No, we've got another ball to roll. So but he's opposite a spare 7. Okay, so that makes the lead 10. Nine it is now. Maintains that lead at 9 at the moment, since Jack Quinn has a 9 box. Now the single pin to pick up right here. He made it. That's a biggie. That is a biggie. Jack Quinn. Oh, yes. A beauty. What a finish. That a strike. What a finish. Incredible. just amazing. Jack Quinn waiting to throw two bonus balls. What a finish. He's already at 138. There's the first bonus ball. A big nine. 147. .396. He's at 100 and he needs a 120. Get that piece of wood out of there. Well, maybe he can get it. A lot of tenseness right now as we watch. Did not hit it hard enough. .118. Now remember, he had 18 pins to begin. Coming in. He needs a spare right now, and he needs two pins to win. He needs a total of 12. Okay, he must make this. He must make this spare. Remember, he had an 18-pin lead coming in. So he needs 11 pins to tie and 12 pins to win. So he must make this spare. This ball counts right now. He made it! Wow, what a clutch spare! What a finish. Jack Quinn rolled a spare and a strike in his last two boxes for a total of 39 pins. And Jeff Atkins had to mark here in the last. He just did, and he needs two pins to win. Two pins to win. He got it. He won it by three. And he gets a 400 on the nose. He wins it by four pins. He needed two. He got five. So he picks up an extra bonus of $100. What a finish, boys and girls. That one is one we will remember for a long, long, long time. Oh, boy, look at that. What a great finish. What a tough loss for Jack Quinn. Final score, Jeff Atkins, 400. Jack Quinn, 396. First of all, before anything, how about a hand for Jeff Atkins and Jack Quinn, huh? Just sensational. Absolutely one of the best matches we have ever had. Ever. Okay, we're going to reach in here and draw a card out. 796 is the total. I don't know whether I'll have a winner or not, but at least you're going to win these prizes.
Flare squares, the easy-to-use 12-inch wall covering squares for decorating your kitchen and bathroom. Just dip in water, slip into place, and sponge dry. And Miracle, America's favorite grass shear by Ames, features precision hollow ground blades for clean, quick-cutting action and soft cushion grips. Easy on the hands. And an Encyclopedia Britannica yearbook, the current book of the year, produced by the publishers of Encyclopedia Britannica 3, the most comprehensive encyclopedia in the English language.
Okay, for $50, anywhere from $786 to $806. I'll go over this side for a change. Dig down underneath here, see what we have. This is Elizabeth Demigian, and remember, it's $786 to $806, and her guess is $845. Okay, so we add another $50. All right, we have $575. Do you want to get? Want to add that to all the money you've made? Okay, Jack. Oh, no. Come on over here, would you please, guys? Jack here and Jeff behind. First of all, this is the little card for the Fisher Space Pen. And I just want to tell you, look, before I do anything, I want to shake your hand. That was a clutch performance.
That was an
I know, but it was a clutch performance by both of you, and you put the pressure on right to the very, very end. You get the smaller trophy. You get $300 for being runner-up, $150 in bonus money. Wish it could be more since you're probably a new daddy by now.
Yeah,
huh?
Maybe.
Right. But, Jack, don't stay away too long. It's been almost 4 years. Anybody who can bowl like that deserves to be here more often, okay?
Thank you.
All right. And, Jeff, what a day, huh?
Pretty good day.
Oh, man.
It was tough, I'll tell you.
I found out that your wife, Lisa, did see it. She was in the back, even though she took Jeff Jr. to the little boy's room. She heard the noise and came back again. $700 for winning, $1,000 for three strikes in a row. You won two of the strings. That was another 100.
I only won one.
Is that right?
Yeah, I only won one. Second string.
That's right, the third one, even though you came from behind.
Right.
Son of a gun. All right. Well, anyway, it's $1,250 as near as I can. You'll take that?
Okay.
All right, you come back next week, and I don't know if you can keep it up or not.
I don't know either.
Wow. Gee, right. You're really on a roll.
Okay.
All right. And we'll be here. See you then. Don Gillis for the whole crew. Bye-bye, everybody.